large, and then this sandstone and start smooth. In the end, you can have two bars. Because work on the limestone car.
This is a stone thread, and one of the things I want to show is I was cutting a half inch off the stone thread so it would fit properly. And this is the piece that's still attached to the other end of the stone. But one of the things I want to show you is stone does bend. Contrary to popular belief, anything like that, concrete, stone, it will bend. Here I have some chisels. This first chisel, like I used on the roping section, is what you call a pitching tool. It has a flat end on it, and it's used for cutting a stone straight down. It'd be like this. This chisel is a pointed chisel, and it's used to get knobs off of a piece of stone. Chisel, just a flat chisel, it can be used for trimming just the edges. We're facing a stone. This is a star chisel. This is what they used in the old days to cut a hole in a stone, like a drill. And you just hit it like this and keep turning. That would be your hole. You'd drill a hole. Once you get the holes drilled, like this, in the old days, they wanted to split a stone, they'd use what is called, which is wedges. They put the wedges in the stone like this, and a chisel between them. And to break the stone, they tap it. That would crack the stone. The only last thing I wanted to show you was anytime you use a sponge, completely rinse it out, and then you sponge your cement off.